Hey, what's up, you guys? It's your girl, Celi Vee. Today, I'm going to teach you guys how to curl your hair. No, we're not leaving this side like that. So I just want to show you guys a quick little intro before and after. So if you guys want to learn how to get your hair like this. You guys stay tuned. Also, make sure you guys like, subscribe, and click that bell so you guys get notified whenever I come out with a new video. It's your girl Celi Vee. Let's jump right into the video. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and just plug in my curler, the Con Air curler, and I'm just going to adjust it to. And adjust it to 330 Fahrenheit. And this one goes all the way up to 400. I'm using 350. I'm just gonna go ahead and let that heat up. And then I will be right back. Alright, so I have this paddle brush. I'm gonna go ahead and just comb out my hair. Just brush it back, and I like to see where I want to part it. Sometimes I like doing a side diagonal, blah blah blah, but I think today I'm gonna go ahead and just do it straight down the middle. So I like to just get something pointy. I like to measure it from my nose. Sit down because I don't think you guys can really see me. Okay. So I'm going to use a heat protective serum. I needed the most for this. Then whatever's left, I like to just take it on my bangs. I'm using a scrunchie. So sometimes what I like to do is I like to just part down the middle, and then I'll just like clip this away. And then I'll work on this side, starting from the back side, going all the way up to the front. But that's when I want more like loose curls. Also, the bigger piece, of course, I'm sure all of you guys already know this, but the bigger piece that you guys get, the more loose curl you'll get, and the less hair that you get, the more tighter the curl is going to be. So for this look, I want kind of like an effortless, kind of like beachy loose curls, since it's summer. So I'm gonna grab one section about this big. Grab that section. Then I'm gonna go ahead and start curling outward from this direction. And I'm taking only the ends. And this is my second day hair. And I like to do second day hair when I usually curl my hair because that it curls a lot more, gets more of a curl. Okay. Second part, I'm gonna go ahead and curl inward just to clean the bottom. So curling inward. Okay. And I'm gonna repeat the same pattern for this side. Inward. look more natural. Okay, that's what we're going for. We're looking like for curls that we look like we didn't even try, even though we did hella work for it. Hella. That's how you guys know that I'm from California. It's like hella. Hella.
I didn't even notice that I say hella until, like, I talk to myself. Well, I'm not really talking to myself, I'm talking to you guys, but I feel like it just comes out sometimes and I don't even catch it until I'm paying attention to what I'm saying more. Does that make sense? Okay. So, I'm gonna go ahead and work from the outer part. And then now I'm just gonna create that pattern, kind of like the first section here that I grab. I'm gonna go ahead and do outward. Second piece, I'm gonna go ahead and do inward, just to create that texture. And then this is how much I'm picking up. Because I don't want to burn my hair, plus my hair's bleached already, so I'm trying to take care of it as much as possible. And this is what outward looks like. So wrapping the hair, I'm sure you guys have seen so many videos like this, but wrapping the hair outward, and just in case I'm the first video you clicked on, you never know. I'm here to help you guys out. So I'm trying to think of the first video ever that I watched on YouTube curling your hair. Oh, I remember. I can't remember her name, but she was doing like a Kim Kardashian curl tutorial. I still remember it. I think I was about 13 when I first started watching YouTube videos. No, wait, I lied. 15. I was 15 when I first started watching YouTube videos. And then there was times where I'll just be in my room just like pretending that I'm like, you know, I would record myself and I would pretend, but I never had the confidence or the like courage to actually do it. I think I was just way too shy. But I would do it in my room by myself though. I see how you did that. So I did outward and then I'm gonna go ahead and do it inward. So continue to keep repeating that pattern. Do you guys like hair extensions? I love hair extensions. I just haven't used them for a few months now. My last hair extensions that I purchased was all the hair extensions. I was gonna do a tutorial on it, but I ended up dyeing my hair blonde. I was just procrastinating it the entire time, like, okay, I'm gonna do the video of the hair extensions, and I never did, and I'm just like, man. So now I have like $400 worth of hair extensions that are just in my drawer, just like, you know, I should have did a video. And that's one thing that I'm working on myself, is like when I think about something, like something creative, I'm like really trying to work on just completing it, you know, because I'm a firm believer of everything happens for a reason, you know, all our actions, everything. Like for example, my reupholstering my couch video, I was gonna take it off because I was just so shy. And that's just something that I'm just building, you know, I'm like shy, like I'm very creative, but you know how a lot of artists, people that are very creative, they're like their worst critic, and sometimes we're like, criticize ourselves way too much, or we overthink things, or we're just shy, and we're just like, you know, I don't know if there's a certain crowd of people that's gonna like understand it, but everything happens for a reason, you never know, right? But yeah, I'm like happy that my most viewed videos, my reupholstering my couch, I guess that's what I'm trying to get out of this entire thing, is that, oh, you know, I was criticizing myself and I was like gonna take the video off, but there's so many people that viewed it. I have almost 10,000 views on that video. And you know, I only have 145 subscribers right now. which I want to thank you guys, by the way. I haven't thanked you guys. I remember thanking my 10 subscribers, but I haven't had a chance to thank my, oops, I did the other way. Give me a blab it on. I didn't get a chance to thank my 100 subscribers, my 145, so thank you guys so much for following me. I appreciate you guys. No matter what pattern I go, as long as I go towards the front part, I always make sure that I curl it outward, because you don't want to curl it inward, because your curl's not going to fall beautifully outward. I'm so extra, mom. I'm so extra for that. For the front part, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is curl everything outward. I want the curls to be a little bit more tighter on the front part, on the top part. Front part, whatever. Alright, so for this part, I'm gonna leave it on just for like 1 second because I don't want to burn. This is the most fragile part I find on me. So I'm gonna take the ends. What I'm gonna do is just kind of run it like that, just twirl it around, and then let it go. I wanna be so careful with that. Alright, so one more time for the front part. So you guys can see what I'm doing. So everything outward. And then this part. Running my fingers through. Not even the end of it, okay? It's nice, huh? Okay, so dry shampoo. I'm using Suave's dry shampoo for all hair types. And I'm gonna start by the back side like this. And just take the crown. See if I can do it this way. So I'm gonna do that. So teasing comb, but anyway, I'm gonna take this non-comb. And then I'm gonna take it down a little. Grab this part. Grab another section. I think I grabbed too much. And I'm gonna take the dry shampoo for the front, back a little bit. Take your teasing comb, whatever comb you have, and I'm just brushing down and then back and forth, taking the front a little bit like that. So it's gonna get like this, right? Take it, push it down. Now everyone loves me for teasing hair. Like I always get everyone if I'm going out, anything, everyone always wants me to tease their hair. So this is a secret. And just brushing it back a little bit, but very gentle, just so that it doesn't look nappy. Okay, now this part's gonna cover it all. So this part, we wanna make sure that we aren't teasing too much, but still teasing to the point that it's not falling over and then giving us gaps and splitting in between. So we wanna make sure that this part is teased. That way it falls over the entire teasing part altogether very nicely. So, I like to spray this very softly, very gently. Taking the teasing comb, teasing that, and I don't really take it in the front part because I want to make sure it's not like extremely teased like everything else. And I'm just letting it fall and then just coming over it very gently. But I'm not brushing all the way down to the curl because I don't want to mess up the curl. Right? And then just fluffing up a little bit. We're not done yet. I'm going to grab the sides now. Let me see if I can show you a before, before and then after. I like to just make sure that it's not any dry shampoo that's showing. I don't want anyone to know we use dry shampoo. It's our secret. I like to grab the end part like this and then just tease a little bit like that. And then brush it out so it doesn't look like I did too much teasing. I love big hair. Do you guys love big hair? I love big hair. There's people that aren't fans of it, but I love big hair. It makes me look just like so before. Alright, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and do this part and I'll be right back. Alright, you guys, this is the finished results. Just a little bit more teasing. You can even grab a little bit of the dry shampoo and just spray it through, but I think I do enough. You don't want it to look like a nest, okay? You want it to look effortless. You can't even tell you took this much time. Enjoyed this video. I hope that it was helpful for you guys. If you guys have any requests, feel free to comment down below. And please comment down below. Let me know how I can go ahead and help you guys in any way possible. And I reply to all of my comments. So yeah, thank you guys so much once again. Thank you guys so much for my 145 subscribers. I can't wait until I get my first 1,000. It's gonna world to me, so I can't wait. Make sure you guys like, subscribe, and also click that bell. I'll be back, you guys. Mm-hmm.